and think about, it made me think about like various highlights, so many, and that moment where we were offered part of this dirt, like this is the last bit of land, with this mandate to take it with you, to carry it with you, to carry those stories, to keep it alive even after it's gone. And it made me think about what we do here, not just like in this weekend, but in our own work, in our own lives. And again, intention. I was at the same session with Allison around art and immigration, and there were these kids that were running around, and it was like that Allison pointed out, like, how amazing that these kids are growing up hearing these conversations, because they're going to pick this up, and they're going to see that art. This is how you express it, and this is how the values of story, and it's just there, like, they're picking it up. And seeing Kathy's daughter in this show, that was just beautiful. It's just so moving. I thought about a piece of the conversation that came up at the art community development around the values that drive this work, and how we get that reminder to take that moment to just think about what are the values that inform what we do, and even like hearing these conversations, like the report packs, it was just again just a reminder for me. Like for us as an organization to articulate those values, for us as a field to articulate those values, for all the way down into your own work to articulate those values. And again, going back to what you were saying about intentions, be intentional. And so these are so many things that have just been buzzing around. And again, like I feel like after these events, it's usually about 3 weeks later where something's like, oh, okay, you know, and it's just a lot to process all in the moment, all right now. But I wanna, you know, I feel like now, like several of you, the other thing that I'm just pretty impressed with is that there's a lot of people who've been to multiple microfests now, like in a good substantial number that've been to all three of them, which is really impressive because like. These happen with a lot of regularity, like every other month, you know, a weekend, somewhere that's really difficult to get to. So that was, I was like, this great moment. But now, it really, a lot of my time is thinking about, like, how are the dots connecting? And how, you know, like, a lot of the same things are coming up, and how it looks different, but so much is the same, and how are we building allies between like ourselves and our hosts in all of these places, between our host communities, and how does that start to ripple out nationally? And there's always been this part of NET that I've valued, which is like trying to build a movement. And that's the part where it gets really exciting and complicated, and I feel like in some ways like overwhelming. And then, you know, I was thinking about what Stephanie said earlier about, like, you know, we're just talking about John, and my earlier, like, when I mentioned, like, places like Oshé and Junebug and Roadside, there's a really long list of people who help pave a path or clear a path. And that are models. That becomes really important because I think sometimes it feels like we're making it all up, and sometimes we are, and because we're gonna make it up the way that makes sense for us, but it's also that reminder that we have these people who can help, these people who help kind of clear that space. And so that also was really, it makes me happy. So all of these, where's all this going? To Hawaii.
Yeah.
We were recently in Honolulu doing some prep work, and it's like all of these communities, it's really, places really complicated. And I think it's like you know, being here in New Orleans, it just also reminded me of like, you have these perceptions of a lot of these places, and New Orleans, there's so much to celebrate, there's so much beauty, and it's you can't mistake the city for any other city in this country. And Honolulu is similar, like it's so beautiful, and it's so complex. what folks, the conversations that folks are having, what folks are dealing with, and it connects so much to the conversations we've been having in all these other cities. And so, I just kind of want to plant the seed, you know, that Allison was saying that we're now at the point where it's time to start connecting dots. It's time to, you know, our hope is that when we get there to Honolulu, it takes a step that starts to gel, and so those connections become all the more important. There's realities, like the part of why we're going to Honolulu, because it's not the easiest place to get to. It's really expensive to get there.
I got here.
But people do it. Exactly, and it's now it's our turn. So it's our turn. We have friends. One thing that we heard a lot from people who are in Honolulu and in Hawaii is that they usually have to come here if you want to engage with your peers. If you want to break that isolation, you've got to come here, because when people go there, they're on vacation, and you know, and you get it. But. What we want to just create that space where we can offer that support, where we can offer what we get out of all of these places. We want to share that with our friends and peers there. And so the dates for Honolulu are June 13th through the 18th. June 13th through the 18th. This coming June, 2013. Registration, we hope, will open up in early, maybe, February. And we want to just give you enough time. And we're still sorting through, like, how to make travel subsidies available. But that is something that we're just aware of. Just like we understand the realities of what it means to travel a long distance. Something that's really important is just to have people in the room. That's what Carol said. If you're not at the table, you might be on the menu. We want you at the table. We won't put you on the menu. Yes, I just wanted to put that out there just to take a moment to extend the invitation. We not only want you there, but we're gonna need you there. If you can once again help us out and join us. Thank you for letting me just kind of get that out of my heart. I really want to acknowledge really briefly Alicia Tonsic, who is sitting in the seen it, and Alicia does that. She knows the fact, she carries those values, and she works that way, and we are a good organization because she brings those skills to this organization, so thank you. We have here Shireen Azab, who has been on our staff for just a few months, and it's been an incredible difference. The work to just get us here. Sabrina Hamilton, like, processing registrations, working with members, it's these jobs are huge, and I really want to thank you all for just like making our organization a better organization. My dear friend who I love so much, Ashley Sparks. She was working with folks here. She had people helping her on the ground, and also like actually taking time to meet individually with people, to go check out sites, Yeah, I mean, it's the work, the list is so big and long, and Ashley does it with grace. She's really amazing, so I want to thank you. So thank you all. We're not done. We have... Yes, we're going to do some more thank yous. This is my favorite part, by the way, because it really comes down to, like, these. We can't, there's never been said enough. Thank you. It's like this moment to just acknowledge what we do. So we're going to keep acknowledging.
Great.
Thank you, Mark. Those include, I wrote my list, I'm not remembering things very well right now. Carlton Turner, Niall Watkins, Bob Leonard, Joe Carson, Tuffy, Bill Roush, MK and Lisa, Kathy DeNabriga, Kathy Randles, Nick Slag, Nicole Garneau. Those are some of my short list of gratitude for those who allow me to be here. And now I'm going to run down a list of the people who also made it possible for those who are from out of town to enjoy today and this weekend. Staff, Mark Valdez, Alicia Thompson, Pam Roberts. Yeah. Support, and that includes folks like, as I say your name, I'm going to stand up because I think that I want cumulatively people to see how many people were actually involved in this. Rebecca Moise, Nicole Garneau, Bonnie, Louisa, Phil Kramer, who is also staff and has been a fabulous volunteer for us, Kathy Randles, Nick Sly, Stephanie McKee, Kyoko, Colette, Rachel Lee, Ron, Aaron, are you in the house? So Aaron, just so you guys know, Aaron stayed at my house for 8 hours waiting for program books. These are the kind of things volunteers do. Because I was doing other things. Hannah Pepper Cunningham, Matthew, Owen. I want to thank Bruce France, who has been like feverishly making all sorts of documentation. As staff, so thank you. Volunteers. Venues, if we had an event at your facility or home, MK and Lisa, please stand up. If you brought people to your home or location, please stand up. The planning team, if you were ever in a group meeting potluck that was epic, please stand up. Awesome, and also, if you were a presenter, if you were at some point leading a conversation, a workshop, yep, Karen, join us, Brian, yep, there we go. So I am only here because of these people and their generosity in making this possible. And so can we just give it up for all these folks? Now we get to my favorite part. Logistics. Great. Okay, so a couple of you have asked about cab rides to the airport. I'm going to encourage you to, those of you who go back to the hotel, to organize yourselves. If you want to take a group cab, you are welcome. Lost and Found. There's a hard drive that was left at Lisa and MK's last night. So if you're maybe missing a hard drive, who knows what's on it? The tonight at 5 o'clock here is a community sing that Miss Michaela has helped organize. And so if you want to come back, it's going to be fabulous. I've done it the past couple years and it's a beautiful event. There are t-shirts for sale made by Tribe One from Appalachia. So Sage has t-shirts for sale over there. They are $15. And immediately following this, the following drivers are going to take folks over to the CAC, who are involved in a second meeting, because we haven't had enough yet. All right, so Rebecca Mosse, Diane, Phil, Bobby B, Will, Trap, and Stephanie McKee. So if we could all gather right over there when everything wraps, we'll take a little 10-minute transition. We'll drive folks over to the CAC. For more meetings. And, you want to announce that? Okay, great. And there is a party. So here's what's going to happen. We're going to,
hey, talk amongst yourselves.
Okay, so, all right. Here's the deal. If you have an announcement for the full group, come and stand right here and make a line. Now, this can be about HowlRound, this can be about whatever's coming up in your life, this can be about your residency, whatever it is. Come make a quick, you have 30 seconds, I'm going to time you. Where's Tannis? Yes. Brett? Tannis, please come and stand in this line.
Wrong time to go to the bathroom, girl.
So this is for anybody who has an announcement they want the full group to know about. I'm going to give you 30 seconds, and I'm shining it.
There's another house party today at my house, which is 1224 North Roshan Lane. You can remember it as Christmas Eve on Roshan Lane. And that will be from 3 o'clock on. So people who are coming back here to sing can either come before or after. We're just staying open. So love to you all. Please come if you're still in town.
Great.
Well, thanks.
Awesome. Good model. Great. 30 seconds.
I encourage everyone here to just check out our website, nacl.org. We have a deep space performance residency. We support 6 groups per year from May to November. We offer a week-long supporting residency with a performance for our amazing community. And many of you have been to our theater and our house. It's a really great place to develop work and meet our people. So please check it out.
Just want to let you know that Fool's Fury is hosting a work in progress series, we're calling it this year, in the second half of July. It's going to be a 10-day event, lots of cross-pollination, training, etc. A chance to show short works in progress on a multiple bill, 10, 20, 40 minutes, get feedback from the community. We're pretty broke, so we don't have a whole lot of money for it, but we really want to open the space and develop cross-pollination, check out
foolsfury.org. Hey, if anyone is sticking around this afternoon, evening, and you did not get a chance to check out Running Down the Mountain on Thursday, we do have a show tonight at 8 p.m. Woo! Especially if you're staying for the scene right here in Ashe. Once it's done, 4 blocks down that way is the Dryads Theater. Please come join us. Thank you.
Every summer, Soju Theater hosts institutes in devising and civic practice. This summer, they'll be in San Francisco and D.C., but also, we're going to be in Honolulu. The MicroFest Summit is June 13th through 18th, and Honolulu Theater for Youth has invited us to stay for 2 extra days. So if you want an excuse to stay for a couple extra days, we're going to do a 2-day workshop in devising and civic practice at the Honolulu Theater for Youth the 2 days following.
Ooh, I'll be there.
Hey, so if you haven't seen HowlRound.com this week, it's H-O-W-L, Round. The fabulous Nick Sly curated a whole NOLA series this week that had about 10 pieces in it, and it's a really lovely thing. You should all check it out. That's also where you'll find all of the archives of the live streaming that was going on this week, as well as everything that we've done in previous MicroFests.
October 17th through the 20th, here in New Orleans, we are celebrating the 50 years of the Free Southern Theater.
So we'd like to invite everyone to a Cultural Organizers Weekend here in New Orleans, the weekend of February 22nd, 23rd, and 24th, sponsored by the Arts and Democracy Project and Urban Bush Women and Junebug in the person of Stephanie McKee. So please come. It's the third annual Cultural Organizers Weekend. It's going to be great. Please check out Andrew Boyd's book, Beautiful Trouble. This is my new Bible.
Awesome. Thank you for your collective announcements. Now, I'm really excited about Honolulu for a lot of reasons. And so as part of the MicroFest, we're doing these little teaser trailers to give you a sense of what's next. And I am very grateful to Vicki Holtz and Moses Goods, because they're going to give you a little sneak peek of one of the things you might see.
Aloha, my uncle.
Aloha.
So we have a few things that we're going to do. Just two things. As promised, we will do a hula for all of you. I will not be taking off my shirt. Thank you very much. You'll see that in Hawaii. You'll get enough of that there. Before we get into this hula, and before I pass it on to Vicki, who really has the manaho, the knowledge of things, I just want to say a few things just to, as we welcome you into our home, just explain what hula is. So we all know that hula is very fun and very entertaining, and that's a huge part of it. It's very much something to be enjoyed. However, hula is also our strongest link that we have to our kupuna. Our kupuna are our ancestors. So in the time when it was against the law for us to practice our culture, it's against the law for us to speak our language, hula survived, and in that was our dances, our stories, our identity, and who we are. So as you enjoy hula, and you will all enjoy hula very much, just keep in mind that this is who we are, this is how we continue to be Hawaiian. And we're going to do a shortened version of a hula right now, entitled Hanawai Mea, and we will share her manaho on that, and after that we'll get to something else.
So, this is a great belly hula. A dance for Moses to do. It's a chant that was written for the warriors of Kamehameha I, who was the king that united the Hawaiian Islands under one kingdom. His work is trained in the forests of Waimea. So we talk about place and we talk about resources. Waimea was where the warriors went to gather the wood, to make their spears, to gather, to train in the forests of Waimea. And the wind and the rain of Waimea is named Kipupu. It's an icy, cold, chilly wind. They like that chilly wind name because when they came in and they used their lua training or their martial arts training, they came across the field and swept the field and always left this bloodshed or the blood-red rain that clung to the peaty grass on the battlefield. They came in like that wind. They tracked their enemies like that wind. And they used these techniques of war, to capture the warriors, to defeat their opponents. But the mele also talks about the love for their people and the love for their loved ones who went into battle. And it talks about the love for their aina, the land, and love for the rain. And so we expect that we will share with you our love for land, our love for our resources, and why we advocate with our artwork to protect those natural resources for future generations so that we don't lose what's been left there for our people to gather, to meet, to learn from, to live off of the land. Ma koko. I, Hanawai Mea,
Good, from the beginning, my keynote. every time you you finish a ho mai, or you modulate up a half step. A ho mai, so you don't want to start too high. Okay. All right, ready? Yes.
Can you tell us what it means?
I will. Right after we, okay, I'll do this now. This is a
good one. I just want to sing it with feeling.
Yes, okay. So, a ho mai means to give or grant. Give or grant the knowledge from above. There's a lot of things that we do that we don't know why we do. It's innate in us, or we don't understand, but when we're really looking for the answers, they manifest it in some way, and we know that it's our ancestors that are giving us those answers, that are guiding us along the path. So what we talk about when Moses talked about kuleana, it's our responsibility because it's who we are. It comes with our family history, our family genealogies, the gut feelings that you know you're doing the right thing. And sometimes we don't want to listen to that. But we know that, and we always come back to it though. They find a way for making us come back. So give us the knowledge from above of those hidden meanings, those things that we don't understand, of, in this particular sense, of the chant, the hidden meanings of the chant. And we expand that chant to mean all of the things that we really don't have ancestral knowledge of because they were so far ahead of, so far before, so far ago. And we're trying to recover that language, that knowledge from our ancestors that was lost. And every one of us has that. And then ehomai, to give us the power to do the work that we do and carry it on. And so we usually start all of our gatherings with this one chant. So to prepare you for coming, we start it every day. At morning when we start, we'll be doing this chant every single morning. And usually at the end of the day, we'll close. So sometimes there's no end to the day though. I'm not sure when the day ended. It hasn't ended yet. So we'll start here and we'll greet you on the shores of Oahu when you come. I would love to have you all join in on this one. Okay. So, three times, anu'u up every single time. Makafau. See, you already understand Hawaiian without me even telling you to hana owa, repeat. You just understand, it's there. Makafau, holy.
Support so we can build a field. We do gatherings and convenings.
We have programs for building in field infrastructure. Check us out on our website if you're a member of NED. Thank you. If you're not a member of NED, we'd like to extend an invitation. Check out our website, www.ensembletheaters.net, and you've got a place here. This is a home for you.
Hey, Mark.
Yes?
And you can join as an individual member, just to say.
You can. The one announcement that did not get made is that we've been doing these you've seen writers here, and we've been working with Animating Democracy, and these papers are up, and so the documentation is up on our website, and on the Animating Democracy website, so it's really beautiful, complex, wonderful papers, documentation, so check those out, I think you like them, and the mixtapes, as we get them going, are also on the website with some photos, so check it out. Thank you again. As you go back to your homes, safe travels, and we will see you in Hawaii. Oh,
yeah, pretty cool.